Welcome to Divine Mercy Parish and our celebration of the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please join in singing our opening hymn, Morning Has Broken.
To our celebration of Eucharist. We gather as God's people in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and peace of Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you.
And with your spirit.
Our gospel invites us today to find our treasure in the Lord, our treasure in faith. So we now pause then to reflect on the treasure of love that God gives to us, extending to us always his mercy, forgiveness, and care.
Lord Jesus, you are the treasure we seek every day. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
In Christ Jesus, you are the truth that brings joy to the world. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And Lord Jesus, you are the Word of God made flesh. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that, with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that endure for those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request, so God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding, so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will come no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, I love your kindness. of your word sheds light, giving understanding to the simple.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Blessed are you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. You have revealed to the little ones the mysteries of the kingdom. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field." And again, "The kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it." And again, "The kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets, and what is bad they throw away. And thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into a fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth." "Do you understand all these things?" And they answered, "Yes." And he replied, "Then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household, who brings from the storeroom both the new and the old." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I heard about these three men that were on an overnight journey hiking through the wilderness. They came upon a very violent, raging river, and they needed to get to the other side. The first man prayed, "Please, God, give me the strength to make it across." God gave him big arms and strong legs, and he was able to swim across in 2 hours. Now, seeing this, the next man said, "God, give me the strength and tools to make it across." God gave access to materials to build a boat. He was able to row across in 30 minutes. Now the next man said, "God, give me the strength, the tools, and the intelligence to make it across." God turned him into a woman. She looked at the map, hiked 5 minutes upstream, and then walked across the bridge. Now it's only a story I heard. But guys, please, please don't get offended, but sometimes we pray for things and God answers in the most mysterious ways. Now for us here today, on a most serious note. My friends, if God were to show up at any time, any place, and say to you, "Ask of anything of me, and I will give it to you," what would be your response? Well, I believe the readings this Sunday are all about seeing and discerning what is most important in our lives. And these readings come at a good time, especially all that's going on in our lives today. If we answer this question honestly, I believe this might shed some light on who we are too. When we are in our spiritual life and how close we are in the kingdom of heaven, it shows our current journey through this corona pandemic. It has its forces. Each of us has to stop and consider what is really important to us. Yes, our lives has been turned upside down, and we have been asked to change how we approach even our most routine of tasks. And for the last several months, we wake day in and day out and do what needs to be done and continue to isolate ourselves from others and attempt to maintain some normal to our lives. And one cannot help but realize through these challenging times what is really important. The significance of God helping us through this, our life and our future, our family and our friends, our hope, our love, and most of all, our faith are brought front and center through this. Now, in our first reading, Camille shared with us, Solomon asked God for the gift of understanding so that he would know what is right. God was delighted with what he asked. For wisdom is a gift that comes from God, and the one that allows us to see what is right and true. It allows us in our journey of life here to find the path to what is ultimately important to us. And when we ask and we receive that gift that only can come from God, then that wisdom leads us to God and into a much deeper relationship with him. For us, it appears that if we look back in our lives at the present time now, and we share our struggles with this current pandemic, and the struggles we're having with racism, selfish privileges, and power, and with all of this, with God's guidance, we can have a peace that God will get us through it. He has in the past, he will in the present, and he will in the future. As believers in our journey of life, we need to pray for that guidance of peace from the Holy Spirit. And for all of us here, we are all too familiar to know how our lives change in a heartbeat. Possibly losing someone we love, losing our jobs, our health, and now that is going on around us in the world. But it's life every day. And we cannot ignore what has happened to us personally or socially, as doing so will only do us the grave harm. But we have to be honest and realize that we focus too much energy on the unimportant, superficial stuff at times, and neglect paying attention to things that really make a difference and have the greatest impact. The love of Jesus for us is the one thing in the midst of all the changing things of life that remains constant and firm. And how we spend our time and how we ponder our life experience and consider the struggles of our world and confront the evils of our day will reveal whether we are serving God's way or just our own way. Once we discover this pearl of great price, we will find ourselves experience profound joy and peace. We will know that we discover something extremely valuable and true. And yes, we all do have a story. Solomon's story brought him to wisdom and understanding. And then in our gospel, we hear how our treasures can be found, and our road and journey cannot be traveled alone. It's only with God and our brothers and sisters, with us, can we discern what is right. Are our hearts open every day to receive Him? And we may ask ourselves, do we have to reset our GPS and reroute our journey to find this treasure, this pearl, Jesus? And personally for myself, I think we do. I think we do each and every day. Because a journey is a journey into our own hearts, and the path has been given to us by Jesus Himself. We just need to be aware of His presence, and we too need to ask as the three men in the wilderness. Pray, ask, and believe. Then we too will discover our pearl, Jesus, a peace and a joy.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and of earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made. For us and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. With humble hearts, we come together seeking the reign of God and giving thanks and praise for this great gift. A response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Holy Father, Francis, our bishops and priests, that they persevere in leading us on the way to conversion and urging all those who are losing hope, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For reverence for all life, from conception to death, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater stewardship in our world, and for greater responsibility to see our resources are used for the good of all, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For wise leaders and brave public servants, working patiently for peace in the violent world, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who work for justice and equality among all peoples, regardless of race, culture, religion, or gender, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all parents who seek insight and guidance, and they ponder their children's options to return to school in the fall, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all who are working to defeat the coronavirus, for strengthened healthcare workers, insight to those researching treatments and cures, and for patients to all who face challenges because of disease, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all who are suffering, and ask for our prayers in a time of need, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loved ones, that they may be justified and glorified with Jesus in heaven, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the names and intentions from your parish book of prayers, and for the intentions we hold now in the silence of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intention of all parishioners, this Mass is offered, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of wisdom, bless us with the gift of the Spirit, that our lives may give witness to the cross and the promise of the resurrection. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
As our gifts are being prepared, please join in singing, Renew Me, Lord.
Oh God, I seek safe harbor in this storm, a place of peace in which my soul can form the inner strength.
Now pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring for the abundance of your gifts, and through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere we are to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we confess with living faith. And his coming again in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you. As without end, we acclaim.
Heaven and earth are full.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather up people to yourself, so that the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice could be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we brought to your consecration, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and give you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and give you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascent into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with this Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. With the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all of your children scattered throughout our world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to the passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, who will bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At our our Savior's commanded form by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. And my friends, may peace and love of Jesus Christ be with each one of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other now a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. We now sit together our spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive your body and blood at Mass, please give me the faith to know that you are always within me. Come into my heart and never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us always, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let's go forth in peace and joy to always love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Have a blessed week.
You too.
Thank you.
As we close our celebration, please join in singing, Let There Be Peace on Earth.